My work focuses on, at the population level, how the lived social experience, environment, space, place, and time manifest themselves on the human body, and how and why demographic groups experience this differentially.
So I was really drawn to the idea of having that 10,000 foot view of research that everybody talks about at NIH, and thinking more broadly about the research landscape and really being able, with that lens, to identify where there are gaps in knowledge that we need to fill in order to move forward. And so I was really drawn to the idea of having that larger impact on science as a whole, as opposed to the more narrow impact I was having as an individual researcher.
The lion's share of NIH funds go to the external research community. Most of it goes to universities, people in universities. There's a portion that goes to small businesses and some large businesses. Because that's the majority of where the funds go, what NIH needs is staff, program staff, we call ourselves, who can manage that process. And that involves a lot of different things. But we mostly oversee the scientific part of the extramural community's work.
My work is a direct fit with the NIH mission. It's the social determinants of health. The NIH-funded social and behavioral science research enhances health, lengthens life, reduces, and I would also add, prevents illness and disability.
So as opposed to being the boots on the ground researcher at an academic institution that I previously was, now I interact with many different researchers about many different research questions. And so I get to engage with them and their projects and think through, you know, all of the different challenges that they need to overcome, how to scope their research to align with the mission and priorities of my institute and center, and also how to scope their research to align with the priorities of that funding opportunity.
Well, my favorite part of the job is working with the external community. That has benefits at many, many levels. One of them is it helps the applicants to understand the process better, know what might make them more competitive for funding, and it makes them realize there's a real person who's behind much of this. I can tell you that the majority of them say to me after I have a conversation with them, we didn't even know we could contact you. We didn't know we could talk to people there. And they're very grateful. But it also helps us internally because we want to make the best informed decisions we can make. If we have better applications, we have more to choose from that are going to be conducting the science that we think is needed and valuable. And our leadership then has better choices to make.
As program directors, not only do we anticipate the direction of the science, but we also play a role in the direction to which the science will shift. Additionally, we get a front row view of the developmental stages of new knowledge. We work with principal investigators in the very beginning stages of their research proposals. We witness peer review. If necessary, we discuss resubmission with the investigators, and once funded, we monitor the progress of the research. It is really a first-hand view of the creation of knowledge, and it is unparalleled.